we're here at Sydney Uni watching Kareem Duncan do some of his dunks. Now we're sitting down having a convo. So I try to understand, you know, how'd you go into dunking and your journey, I guess.
Yeah.
So first of all, how did you get into dunking?
The first time when I took part in interesting in dunking was when I was in high school, like 17.
Yeah.
And I used to play basketball, like strip or like freestyle, you know.
Yeah.
And then I hang the limb just on somehow, and then.
So while you were jumping, and finally you got to hang on the rim.
Yeah.
How'd that feel?
Oh, amazing! Yeah. I couldn't sleep. I just stayed up night, and I was like,
just kept thinking about it.
Yeah.
Kept thinking about it.
Yeah.
Now, you work full time right now, right?
Yeah, 6 days a week. Yeah.
6 days a week.
Yeah.
And you find time to work on your craft, to work on dunking. Tell me a bit about your schedule. Like, how do you fit work and then basketball and your personal life?
I actually have to try and save money as well, and then I have to get in shape at the same time. It's pretty hard, but I have to wake up like 5:30, and I have to get there 7 o'clock. After finish work, normally I finish at 3 o'clock, or 3 o'clock.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's really tired sometimes.
Yeah.
So I always take an hour after work straight away. Obviously, if I want to do dunking or training.
Yeah.
So always do some work, and then sometimes I do like strength training, and then next day I just recover after work, do nothing, just nap or eating just healthy food.
Yeah.
And then next day, some like power training. If I'm fresh, depend, you know?
Yeah.
And then like if I finish early, like the Thursday or Friday or on the weekend, then I do some recovery sessions. Mm-hmm. If I get time, then.
So what's in your recovery session? So like
pool? I actually try everything, like swimming pool, recovery, and then
cryotherapy,
and then hyperbaric oxygen, flotation tank, yeah.
Flotation tank?
Yeah, as well, yeah.
Is it where you like just float and you relax?
Yeah, it's kind of.
Flotation. Oh, fucking stupid word, did I sound? It's in the name. Flotation tank. What do? Float and relax?
That was hard, man. Oh, shit.
When they shooting the
ball? We're at Sydenham Court, home of Ballers Way. We got Korean Dunker here, about to put on a show, or not.
Is that good?
Yeah! Let me see it.
We're here, Lodgebury. This is my cryotherapy. This is like a part of my recovery. Come check it out.
How many fingers am I holding up?
For medical reasons, he has to keep speaking. So if he can't form a full sentence, I think something's wrong, he needs to get out.
-130 before.
Yeah. So this is okay. -125. It's not that cough. I know it sounds like it's freezing, but when you're in there, I feel like your adrenaline kind of takes over. So you don't feel it as much as you would.
Yeah.
Nearly done, you've got 25 seconds.
How long was you in there for?
3 minutes.
3 minutes and that's it?
3 minutes and then that's it, honey. Yeah, you can feel it. It's like
semi-cold-ish.
Oh, yeah, I can feel it.
You can't talk that down.
It's cold. Pass you a rope as well, okay? There you go. How are you feeling?
Oh, yeah.
You're okay?
It'll be fine after it.
Wow, that's cold.
Must be.
And we're here again doing another interview. This time with Kyo Lee, Korean dunker. We're here at Fitness First, George Street. Platinum First, Fitness First. Ah, f***ing hell. We're at Fitness First, Wynyard, George Street. Checking out Korean dunkers' jumps. I mean, look.
Woo! Been having that shit on, nigga. Dripping to the floor, to the door, nigga, you hear me?
My goddamn cup. Yeah.
Yikes, the green seal.
We set the trends. Bringing it in. Bringing it in. I'ma have to call my account to make sure the shit came in. It's just me and my gang. Gang niggas. One do friend. What he say he won't smoke? Smoke. We gon' spin. Spin again. I've been trying to get the money. I've been trying to put a pound. Get the down. Wanna see me win. No. I was thinking about the rolling, but I went and cut the riches. Then I went and put my mama in the Benz. I get it in.
When I came here first time, when I for walking holiday, I always didn't care about the food and the nutrition and the COVID stuff.
Anything, right?
Yeah. And then I always get injured again because I got an overtraining on my body. So
I find that very important. You have to eat well.
Yes.
It plays a factor into injury.
Yeah.
If you don't eat well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, first time when I came here, first of the year, my vertical was totally decreased because I always work hard and then.
The vertical totally decreased.
Yeah, decrease, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Because from all construction shit, so.
Yeah.
So it's really hard, but I just did it somehow. And then, since I'm getting old, right now I'm 30 now, so. Since I need to care about nutrition and recovery stuff, because I just prevent for injury.
Yeah, of course.
So, that's why I'm trying to care about nutrition and then recovery stuff, everything.
Yeah.
Then I can feel, my body is getting better and I feel better. I can't do anything after work,
Yeah.
So.
But now since you've been eating good, you got that type of energy after work to train a bit more.
Yeah. Especially since COVID started and then I can't do anything, then I can't play anything doing some drinking and then traveling something.
I
just do the focus on my own things.
That's it.
Yeah.
Just focus, man.
So we are here in Prince Alfred Park, also known as Central Courts, what everyone calls it. So we're here with Kareem Dunker, about to put on a show for everyone. Dunks, same thing as last time. Shout out, Hidden Hoops.
Talk about your ACL, because coming back from an ACL injury, what made you not choose surgery? Because I remember you telling me you treated it yourself.
I actually went to the medical center and I checked everything, the X-ray and the MRI, and then some hospital say, you might need surgery, but I don't really trust.
Money.
Yeah.
I just want money.
Yeah. So I went to university, the hospital, they more honest. So
research,
So I just take the MRI research and then show them in the hospital. Then they say you don't need to. Then I just decided and just do the rehab and just trying to get in shape. I know I'm getting old, so it's pretty hard to get in shape and increase my body cool, but I'm just trying to my best. And then
of course, man.
If I don't try, then I'm gonna regret it. In the future.
So. You're gonna regret it in the future.
Yeah, exactly. Just do it first. Yeah. I'm gonna go back Korea, but I just trying to do my best as much as I can for challenging my limited for athletic, for dunking to my best. And then once I go back Korea, I just want to make some athletic world for dunking or basketball.
Yeah. If we come to Korea, do you take care of us?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
All
right, we're here at Ultima at Iggy's spot. We just finished cryotherapy for QO. Now this is the other part of his active recovery, the pool session. Let's go, check it out, man.
Poor lost weight.
There you go. They're really inspiring a whole country into introducing a new type of. A new feel to basketball, so it's not just dribbling and all that. You want to introduce the whole dunking and the athletic aspect of it.
Yeah.
just a different style.
Yeah.
I know what you mean, because there's not many dunkers in Asia. I'm not sure about China.
China has a lot of trouble dunkers.
China has, but yeah.
Even I have friends, but yeah. I was planning to go to China, but yeah, I got some mistake.
Everything happens for a reason. You're here in Australia, you know?
Yeah.
You're expanding outside of Asia. Now you go back to Korea.
Yeah.
You know, you got a good name.
Yeah.
You can be a face of something big over there.
Yeah. So I communicate with other pro dunkers in overseas, like Jordan Keegan or like Philippine dunkers,
what's the name?
L. David. Mm. Yeah, it's my name. Instagram name.
Yeah.
And then we communicate like Australian dunker and other dunkers, and then I'm just always telling them like about like what I want to do, what I'm gonna do.
Yeah.
When I go back Korea or here or so.
That was
Yeah.
Who would you say is the best dunker in the world right now? Kilgannon.
Like the person that I watching in person or like in the video, even in the video.
Everywhere, anywhere. Who's the best dunker right now?
There's too many.
Yeah. You're
top three. Yeah. For me, I think Jordan Keegannon, yeah. He's
Jordan
the best.
Kilgannon?
Because he got a lot of like handling skill for dunking and then
So yeah, man, his dunks are crazy,
yeah.
Behind the back,
yeah.
The both arms in the
The crown, yeah.
Yeah, that's sick. Nah, he's good.
Yeah, I'm trying to.
He really doesn't. He's the type of person that doesn't look like he's a dunker, and then he'll just jump out the gym.
Yeah, when I saw him first time in the person, actually that was when I came the first time. Then when I saw him, he looks like a little bit weak.
He might hear this.
Yeah, he looks like a little bit like kind of like relaxed, and then he looks like
and I don't know, it's just
tired. But when he did the dunking, and he was like, wow, man, crazy. Yeah.
Yes, I seen this video how he just surprised people. He just out of nowhere, boom.
Yeah.
And it was like, whoa, what the hell?